This Lucidchart tutorial will show you how to create a diagram that outlines the timing and dependencies of various steps in a complex process. If you're familiar with PERT diagrams, then you already know the value of documenting start time, duration, and float. But for those of you who have never even heard of PERT, this tutorial will give you everything you need to create a dynamic plan for your next project. If you've worked with PERT or critical path charts in the past, you know how useful they can be in helping you understand the minimum amount of time it will take to complete a given project. They help you outline simultaneous tasks, track dependencies, and keep your team on track to meet tight deadlines. In this tutorial, we'll show you how to use Lucidchart to automate your PERT chart so the information in the project spreadsheet links directly to your chart, automatically updates information in your diagram as the project evolves, and dynamically adjusts the critical path each time you make changes to your plan. We'll also show you some tips for effortlessly sharing the latest version of your diagram with your team at all times. We're using this example of a software product launch for this tutorial. As you can see, we have all the tasks associated with our project outlined here, along with start and finish times, duration, and slack. Not only is all the information in this diagram dynamically linked to the spreadsheet where we have all the project information, but this red arrow is reading the data of each shape and automatically identifying the critical path for our project based on the data in our spreadsheet. So let's get started. First, let's look at the details of my project. Right now, I have a list of tasks that need to be accomplished, how long each of them will take, and a list of their dependencies. For example, testing the hardware is dependent on first launching the prototype. The first thing I'll do with this list is quickly draw up the various pathways that will take this project through to completion by opening Lucidchart and building a really quick map of the project. I'll pull out a process shape, label it A, then use my favorite keyboard shortcut to quickly build out the rest of this process. Just press and hold the Alt key and click and drag away from the shape you want to copy. I'll do this a few times and start labeling these shapes and dragging them in order based upon their dependencies. For example, B, C, and D are all dependent on A. Now I can see that I have three pathways. Let's move back into our spreadsheet and finish entering the information we'll need for our automated PERT chart. Next, I'll create formulas to calculate the duration of each pathway, and then a quick formula that identifies my critical path. We'll use this to automate our chart a little later on. You can find a link to this spreadsheet with formulas and instructions in the template linked in the description of this video. Now that my data is properly calculating in sheets, I'm ready to move into Lucidchart and start working on my diagram. I'm going to use a table shape, which I can quickly find using the search button at the top of the toolbox on the left side of the editor. I'll type tables and pull this table directly onto the canvas. From here, I'll format the shape to my liking. Like, let's create a header row for the name of each task by holding Shift while clicking each of these cells, then selecting Merge from the options in the banner. I'll make this row blue, and I'll make the text white and a little bigger. Next, I'll select each of the cells below and make the text slightly bigger and bold. Let's add data to this diagram. Start by clicking the Data button in the dock on the right side of the editor. Then click Link Data. You have the option of choosing data from Sheets, Excel, and CSV. The benefits of using Sheets is that any updates in my data set will be automatically pushed into Lucidchart. Excel and CSV data will require me to replace the data set in Lucidchart each time I want to update the data in my diagram. It's easy, but it's not automatic the way Google Sheets is. The data from my spreadsheet appears in the bottom half of the data panel on the right. To add data to my shape, I'll click an entire row of data and drag it onto my table. When I release the mouse, it looks like nothing has happened, except that now I'm seeing new data in the top half of the data panel. As you can see from the label at the top of the panel, this data is associated with my table shape, and I can now customize how I want the data to appear. I'll double-click into the header row of my table, then come back to the Shape Data panel and select the plus T next to the A label. Press spacebar a few times to add some space between the label and the title, then click plus T next to the name of this task. I'll add the data that I want visible on the rest of the shape using the same plus T button. I can customize how everything looks by adding spaces or formatting the text at any time. If you make a mistake, just delete the data using the delete key on your keyboard, then adding the correct data. Once I have the shape looking exactly the way I want, I'm going to use the handy keyboard shortcut again and press and hold Alt, then click and drag away from this data linked shape. Lucidchart creates an exact copy, and I can move it wherever I would like on the canvas. You can also save this new shape as a custom shape and then use it in multiple projects or share it with the rest of your team to really expedite future PERT charts. Click the button on the top right corner of this video if you want to learn more about how to set up custom shapes. While I have all the shapes placed, I'll go ahead and add arrows between everything. Now watch closely because this is where the hard work pays off. I'll click and drag the next row of data from my design hardware steps onto the canvas and drop it onto the new shape. Lucidchart asks if I want to replace the data, and instantly all of the new data maps to this shape. I'll also add data to each line by clicking and dragging the data onto them, or selecting them and dragging data up into the top half of the data panel to apply it to any selected objects. I don't want to display any specific data on my lines, but I do want Lucidchart to use this data to automatically draw out my critical path when the time comes. Listen up, because this can get a little tricky. In general, lines should be assigned data for the shapes they're leading to. For example, I'll drag the data for B, design hardware, onto this line and drop it. However, when you have multiple lines leading into a single shape, you'll instead want to assign shape data from the previous shape to that line. Otherwise, your critical path won't display correctly. So because there are two lines leading into the test hardware step, I'll assign this line the data for the previous step, E, release prototype, and I'll assign the line for the data for C, create test plan. I'll repeat this for all the other tasks and arrows in our project, and within seconds, we have all the data mapped. When I change anything in my spreadsheet, the updates automatically change in my diagram. Sweet. Okay. Now let's make this diagram even more automated and awesome by having Lucidchart highlight the critical path for our project, or, said another way, let's have Lucidchart show us which tasks need to stick to their deadlines in order for the project to finish on time. We'll use conditional formatting in Lucidchart to get the lines of the diagram to automatically highlight our critical path. Start by clicking on the conditional formatting button in the dock on the right side of the editor. It's the last button on the bottom. Then click Create New Rule. I'll make it a habit to always name the new rules as soon as I create them, so it's easy to identify them. So we'll click on the name of the top of the panel and call this Critical Path. Now we'll move through each of these options for conditional formatting. We want to format our lines, so we'll keep Shape Formatting selected. Next, we'll tell Lucidchart to look at the shape data, tell it what area of our spreadsheet to reference, which, in this case, is our critical column. The next dropdown gives us lots of options for Lucidchart to decipher our data. We want to see if this cell contains the word true. Now we get to customize how our line will be formatted if the rule we just created is triggered. I want to make the line bright red and increase its width. I can apply this rule to all the lines in my diagram by selecting everything on the canvas with the keyboard shortcut Command plus A, or by clicking and dragging my mouse over all the shapes, then dragging this rule either onto the shapes I've selected or just up into the Applied To section. Once I do, Lucidchart automatically reads all the data of my shapes and lines and triggers the conditional formatting we just created. I can clearly see my critical path for this project. Just to test this, let's go back into our spreadsheet and change the duration of some of our tasks. This increase in duration changes the start and finish time of several tasks, as you can see. These changes are all automatically pushed to Lucidchart, and the critical path updates based on this new information. You can share this with your team by either clicking Share and adding their email addresses, setting permissions and sending it to them, or you can simply share a URL of this diagram by clicking Advanced in the Sharing options, clicking Publish, and then publishing a link. Send this link to your team and they'll always see the most recent version of your diagram. Better yet, embed it into a Jira story or Confluence page for easy reference. Instead of manually calculating changes to your projects, updating your critical path, and sending multiple versions of the chart to others, Lucidchart allows you to set up data-linked shapes, apply conditional formatting rules, and then automatically see the details of your project and your critical path. For more videos on how Lucidchart can help you visualize projects, collaborate with your team, and be more productive in your job, check out our video tutorial playlist, or click on the link in the video description to see how other project managers and operations professionals use Lucidchart.